Now the valley of Siddim was dotted with bitumen pits, and the kings of Sodom and Gomorrah in their flight threw themselves into them, while the rest escaped to the hill country. The invaders seized all the wealth of Sodom and Gomorrah, and all their provisions, and went their way. They also took Lot, the son of Abram's brother, and his possessions, and departed, for he had settled in Sodom. A fugitive brought the news to Abram the Hebrew, who was dwelling at the terebinths of Mamre, the Amorite kinsmen of Eshcol and Aner, these being Abram's allies. When Abram heard that his kinsmen had been taken captive, he mustered his retainers, born into his household, numbering 318, and went in pursuit as far as Dan. At night, he and his servants deployed against them and defeated them, and he pursued them as far as Hobah, which is north of Damascus. He brought back all the possessions. He also brought back his kinsman Lot and his possessions, and the women and the rest of the people. When he returned from defeating Chedorlaomer and the kings with him, the king of Sodom came out to meet him in the valley of Shaveh, which is the valley of the king. And King Melchizedek of Salem brought out bread and wine. He was a priest of God Most High. He blessed him, saying, "Blessed be Abram of God Most High, creator of heaven and earth. And blessed be God Most High, who has delivered your foes into your hand." And Abram gave him a tenth of everything. Then the king of Sodom said to Abram, "Give me the persons and take the possessions for yourself." But Abram said to the king of Sodom, "I swear to the Lord God Most High, creator of heaven and earth, I will not take so much as a thread or a sandal strap of what is yours. You shall not say, 'It is I who made Abram rich.' For me, nothing but what my servants have used up. As for the share of the men who went with me, Aner, Eshcol, and Mamre, let them take their share." Sometime later, the word of the Lord came to Abram in a vision. He said, "Fear not, Abram. I am a shield to you. Your reward shall be very great." But Abram said, "O Lord God, what can you give me, seeing that I shall die childless? And the one in charge of my household is Damasek Eliezer." Abram said further, "Since you have granted me no offspring, my steward will be my heir." The word of the Lord came to him in reply, "That one shall not be your heir. None but your very own issue shall be your heir." He took him outside and said, "Look toward heaven and count the stars if you are able to count them." And he added, "So shall your offspring be." And because he put his trust in the Lord, he reckoned it to his merit. Then he said to him, "I am the Lord who brought you out from Ur of the Chaldeans to assign this land to you as a possession." And he said, "O Lord God, how shall I know that I'm to possess it?" He answered, "Bring me a three-year-old heifer, a three-year-old she-goat, a three-year-old ram, a turtle dove, and a young bird." He brought him all these and cut them in two, placing each half opposite the other. but he did not cut up the bird. Birds of prey came down upon the carcasses, and Abraham drove them away. As the sun was about to set, a deep sleep fell on Abraham, and a great dark dread descended upon him. And he said to Abraham, "Know well that your offspring shall be strangers in a land not theirs, and they shall be enslaved and oppressed 400 years. But I will execute judgment on the nation they shall serve, and in the end they shall go free with great wealth. As for you, you shall go to your fathers in peace. You shall be buried at a ripe old age. And they shall return here in the fourth generation, for the iniquity of the Amorites is not yet complete." When the sun set and it was very dark, there appeared a smoking oven and a flaming torch which passed between those pieces. On that day the Lord made a covenant with Abraham, saying, "To your offspring I assign this land, from the river of Egypt to the great river, the river Euphrates, the Kenites, Kenizzites, the Kadmonites, the Hittites, the Perizzites, the Rephaim, the Amorites, the Canaanites, the Girgashites, and the Jebusites." Sarai, Abraham's wife, had borne him no children. She had an Egyptian maidservant whose name was Hagar. And Sarai said to Abraham, "Look, the Lord has kept me from bearing. Consort with my maid, perhaps I shall have a son through her." And Abraham heeded Sarai's request. So Sarai, Abraham's wife, took her maid Hagar the Egyptian. After Abraham had dwelt in the land of Canaan 10 years, and gave her to her husband Abraham as concubine, he cohabited with Hagar, and she conceived. And when she saw that she had conceived, her mistress was lowered in her esteem. And Sarai said to Abraham, "The wrong done me is your fault. I myself put my maid in your bosom. Now that she sees that she is pregnant, I am lowered in her esteem. The Lord decide between you and me," Abraham said to Sarai. "Your maid is in your hands. Deal with her as you think right." Then Sarai treated her harshly, and she ran away from her. An angel of the Lord found her by a spring of water in the wilderness, the spring on the road to Shur, and said, "Hagar, slave of Sarai, where have you come from and where are you going?" And she said, "I am running away from my mistress Sarai." And the angel of the Lord said to her, "Go back to your mistress and submit to her harsh treatment." And the angel of the Lord said to her, "I will greatly increase your offspring, and they shall be too many to count." The angel of the Lord said to her further, "Behold, you are with child and shall bear a son. You shall call him Ishmael, for the Lord has paid heed to your suffering. He shall be a wild ass of a man, his hand against everyone, and everyone's hand against him. He shall dwell alongside all of his kinsmen." And she called the Lord who spoke to her, "You are El Roy," by which she meant, "Have I not gone on seeing after he saw me?" Therefore the well was called Belahai Roy. It is between Kadesh and Bered.